Hi everyone, it's Amy from St. Peter's United Church. Welcome to my short how-to video on how to make your own finger labyrinth. Since we can't walk the labyrinth at the Lord's Grotto in Sudbury this year for World Labyrinth Day on Saturday, May 2nd, we thought that we could all make finger labyrinths and then walk them collectively online using our fingers instead of our feet. Of course, it's a great meditational tool to use anytime, especially during these stressful days. So first I will show you how to draw your own 7-circuit classical labyrinth. I tried some printable ones from the web, but they never came out the right size. This way you can make one that fits your finger exactly. So I begin usually by folding it a little bit in half, just to get the center of your page right for the beginning of your labyrinth. So we want to go 2/3 down the page, so about here, and draw a cross. Next thing we do is draw 4 brackets in each of these corners, and make sure you have a finger width between your cross and your brackets. And it's best to do in pencil, then you can always erase. So the next thing to do is to put dots diagonally from the corners of your brackets, about the same width apart. So that's our basic template, the seed pattern. So we start with the top of the cross right in the middle, and we join it to the next point, which is the bracket, clockwise. So we're going clockwise, but we're going counterclockwise in our first points from where we draw. So we go counterclockwise to the bracket, but then we draw clockwise to the next point, which is our dot. And then if we go counterclockwise again, we have our dot, and then we go all the way to our upper right bracket. Then counterclockwise from here again, our upper left bracket. Go around, try to keep the same width, and all the way down to the right part of our cross. Then the next one is the left part of our cross. Go out and around all the way down to our lower right bracket, lower left bracket, all the way around again, to our dot on the lower right. Next one is the lower left dot, all the way around to our lower right bracket. So just join it up like that. And the last one comes from here, our lower left bracket. Draw it all the way around. Oops. Then we come right up the center to finish at the bottom of our cross that we started with. So, not perfect, but pretty good. And you can erase and practice on rough paper before you do your cardstock or your construction paper that you'll want to use for your actual labyrinth. And if you're a kid, you get your parents to draw you the template for you, and then you can decorate it with whatever you like. My daughter Fiona, on top of hers, she did a Frozen theme with some stickers and some glitter glue. And that's also a great way to go around the paths with the glitter glue. And if you need written down instructions to this pattern for the labyrinth, go to sacredsouth.org/resources. And there you have a printout
with written instructions of how I just drew that labyrinth. And you can get creative, color the lines different colors, add background colors, stickers, whatever you want. And to make your labyrinth easier to navigate, it's nice to have raised lines for your finger to travel between. So this one I did with yarn, and all I did was follow the lines with white glue, and then take two lengths of yarn and follow the lines. So I think I started here and ended there, started here and ended there, but you'll figure it out. It's pretty easy once you start it. And another one I did on construction paper is a sand labyrinth. So I did the same thing, follow the lines with white glue and just sprinkle some sand all over it. This is driveway sand, so it's a little rough, but I kind of like the effect. It's nice and tactile, and yeah, it's got a nice effect. So just use whatever you've got. Some people use puffy paint if they've got it. I know there's some online recipes for that. You could use twine, string, ribbon, beads, seeds, grains, whatever you have. And if you want, you could post pictures of your creations on the St. Peter's United Church Facebook page. And make sure you make one for each person who wants to participate in our virtual labyrinth walk on World Labyrinth Day. So, once you have it ready, go to the St. Peter's United Church Sudbury channel on YouTube, and it will be live at 12:45 for you to join us. And we will walk as one at one. Hope to see you then. Bye.